So the last Lamb of God single was actually pretty good, so let's see if they can keep it together for Omens. As always, I will be skipping around, editing, providing commentary for copyright reasons, and if you don't like it, you can just get out. Okay, we're in the attic. Okay. Starting off with a nice bluesy riff here. Good groove so far. Not bad, not bad. Good start. I'm into it so far. We'll see what happens with the chorus. I've never been a huge fan of when Randy does the more kind of like Yarly, like Hetfield / Phil Anselmo style vocals, but that one wasn't too bad. We head into the chorus, because I'm curious. That's going to be the bread and butter here. This is definitely a very much like a live track. I could see them getting the crowd screaming, "Omens!" together. Omens. The style of the track reminds me a bit of stuff like Redneck, which aren't my favorite Lamb of God tracks, but it's pretty solid. Definitely leaning more into that bluesy angle. That was kind of fun. Little drop there. I'm always a sucker for little moments like that. Little flavor touches in your songwriting. Keep people interested. I will say this riff is a little bit generic sounding. It definitely feels a bit recycled from their older catalog. Very, very just kind of simplistic. So, it's fine though. I feel like I'm getting to the point where I'm wanting something different to happen. So I'm hoping they've got a little bit more to offer here. Something to shake things up. Dang, that guy had done solid, swallowed his last sword. Yeah, again, this chorus, it's fine. It's just basically consists of saying omens a lot of times and a very kind of half-baked riff. I'm interested in where the connection with this like freak show imagery is too. Like, music videos and their songs don't have to like align, but it feels a little kind of just random. All right, we got a bridge coming here. We'll see what happens. Also, very familiar riffing, which again, as some people, the Lamb of God riffs have all sounded the same. It's like, yeah, they've always had a very distinct style, but they've still managed to incorporate like different riffs each time. I was just having this conversation about like the Black Dahlia Murder too. Like, you can have all your music sound similar and still like have each song hit because the songwriting's really good. This one feels a little bit on the kind of needed a little bit more time in the oven kind of vibe. God, she done set herself on fire. Is this all this is going to be, too? Is just the same riff, just, like, escalating in volume? Okay, here we go. This part does remind me of some of the stuff off of, like, Ashes of the Wake era, which is cool, but it doesn't have the same intensity to it. And just the... It doesn't benefit from being as fresh, too, as that album was when it came out. Solid scream. We'll give Randy that. Again, I gave him credit for that in the last song. I think his voice sounds pretty darn good on these new ones. And still better than anything on the self-titled album, I'm feeling like. That's always fun. A good little, like, kind of stall out and then come in with the big vocals and the groove comes back in. Good, decent songwriting there. fun little outro stuff here. It's fine. That was the whole point in the attic, is he's just watching it up there. What a weird little bookend. Well, anyways, that was Lamb of God with Omens. And let's just jump right into the scales. In terms of enjoyability, it's kind of like a 7 or 8 in that realm. Like, I could jam to it. I think listening to it a few more times would probably get its hooks into me. And it's a track you can have fun with. I'll give it that. It's nothing amazing on that level. It's definitely not a 9 or a 10. But, you know, it's fun. Like I said, it'll be a really good live track that I think the audience is going to have fun participating with. In terms of musicianship, it's also like a 7 or an 8, really. Like, just really recycled sounding generic groove riffs that I've heard like a billion times before. I think that it's produced well. It's put together pretty decently. The songwriting isn't bad. It's just, I expect a little bit more. Like, I know that they're capable of writing more interesting riffs than this. And not just like, even though I fanboy over Ashes of the Wake and As the Palaces Burn, they have plenty of modern albums with really great riffs, too. Like, there's a lot of stuff on Sturm und Drang in particular that I thought was really good and just, like, really killed it. Not so much here. Again, definitely better sounding overall than anything on the self-titled album, but nothing particularly special and of note going on here. And then in terms of innovation, definitely a 7, kind of for those same reasons. Just very sort of paint by numbers Lamb of God, done in a way that's fun, not bad, but not great either. So overall, I'm feeling more of kind of like a C plus for this one. It's decent, but I just don't think it's going to be really deserving of major accolades. As always, this is just my initial impression, so let me know down in the comments, what do you think, especially maybe after you've listened to it a couple times. Fuck you, as always, if you get mad that I pause all the time and, God forbid, provide, like, original content instead of just watching the song. Go fucking watch the song. And also, I just put up my favorite albums of July lists. You can check that out right here. But that'll do it for now. Flight of Icarus signing off, and I will see you in the trenches.